Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm making this video on request of one of my clients called Godrej, but I'm hoping this video would be useful for a lot of you out there, so I put it up on my YouTube channel. The video today is on innovation skills. So let's start with understanding what is the importance of innovation in today's time. The first thing I want you to remember is that innovation is not a luxury in today's time, it's a necessity. I'll repeat that, innovation is not a luxury, it is a necessity. Now, what do I really mean by that? You know, there was a time when people thought innovation is something that we need to do once upon a time, once over a period of time, or once in a while. But that was a luxury. You know, maybe you want to come up with an iPhone, you do some innovation, or you make a new product in your company and you do some innovation, or you want to solve a problem and maybe you try to think out of the box. But that was ages ago, a decade ago, when the competition wasn't as high as it is today. Today, innovation is not just a luxury, it is a necessity. And what I mean by that is that today, innovation is required daily for survival, to grow every single day in your life. I'll give you some examples. Look at grocery stores today. If you go as a customer, you demand more and more from grocery stores today. Why? Because companies like Big Bazaar, companies like More, companies like many other superstores like Walmart internationally have raised their standards by innovating in such a way that any normal customer who comes to these grocery stores experiences a beautiful environment, a rich environment in where they can shop, irrelevant of what's their level of income. They've got all kind of products there. That's been an innovation that has completely changed the retail industry today, right? So now, what are these small superstores doing? Are they able to survive? Well, some are not, but some are. The ones who are not surviving are the ones who are not innovating. But the ones who are surviving, I'm telling you, they're innovating every day. Because their customers want to know what new can they get from them. Their customers want to know what innovation do they have in their services, in their products, in the range of products that they keep. Not just that, look at the entertainment industry. Movies are trying to innovate every single day because the customers are asking, the viewers are asking for something new every single day. The demand has gone high. The competition has gone high. So innovation is something you have to do every day today. And you don't only have to look at industries around you. Look at your own office. Look at your own career. If you want to get a promotion today, what people do and what you do is really being good at your job is probably enough to get a 3 out of 5 rating in your appraisal at the end of the year. But if somebody wants a 4 out of 5 or a 5 out of 5, which is seemingly impossible to get nowadays in organizations, but some do with a very few numbers out there. But those who get these 4 or 5 out of 5s are those people who are constantly innovating in the way they deal with their boss, in the way they do their work, in the way they perform on a daily basis, in the way they deal with their clients. They're performing, they are innovating every day. What I'm saying is, innovation is not about doing something big once in a while anymore. It's not a luxury. It's a necessity. You need to do it every day, right? That is how important innovation is. In fact, look at politics. Politics had stopped innovating for some time and then suddenly came up Narendra Modi and the way he campaigned himself. Today, Narendra Modi's win as BJP has kind of created history in the way he's won, because he's used social media, he's used WhatsApp, he's used Facebook, he's used YouTube channels, he's used Google Hangouts, he's used national radio to communicate with people. And he's doing things which no other prime minister ever did before this. So what I'm trying to tell you is this. Innovation is required today in every area of your life, every day. It's not something you can do once in a while, like a luxury the way you used to, but it's something that you will have to do every day today because it's a necessity. Okay, so that's how important innovation is. Now let's understand the second point about innovation. What is innovation? Is innovation simply a good idea? Because that's what most people think it is. It's a myth that innovation is a great idea or thinking out of the box. The moment you have an idea, it's innovation, but not really. Now, the reason I'm saying that is because think about Thomas Edison. Thomas Edison is the man who created the bulb. But question is that when he created the bulb, was he the only scientist working on that invention at that point of time? I'm pretty sure not. There must have been other colleagues of his maybe working on solving the same problem of electricity and creating the bulb at that time. But why is Thomas Edison known as the inventor of the bulb? For a simple reason, because he was the one who successfully executed that idea, right? While many others might be working on that idea and failing and succeeding and failing and succeeding, but the only man who really successfully executed that idea completely was Thomas Edison. So he got to be recognized as the inventor of the bulb, right? Similarly, McDonald's was invented by McDonald's himself. So the franchisee system, the way he does his business, Pizza Hut, KFC, we talk about Subway, talk about Joshi Wadewale in Pune, and I talk about any company who's done big today. Their innovation is not something that was completely new to them. Many thousands, and I'm repeating, thousands of people had the same idea that these people had. But the difference in these companies or individuals who took it ahead were the ones who executed that idea successfully, and that's why they were termed as the innovators of our age, right? Haven't you had this experience where you had an idea 10 years ago, maybe 4 years ago, maybe 3 years ago, and you thought, wow, this could change the world, or you thought this could take your career to the next level? And then a few years down the line, or maybe a few months down the line, you saw somebody else implementing that idea, right? And you were like, oh my God, I thought of this idea so long ago. But what's the difference between you and them, or between me who thought of an idea and somebody else? Well, the difference is pretty simple. That person took that idea to successfully execute it. That's the difference. So what is really innovation? For me, innovation, the definition is, innovation is the successful implementation of an idea. An idea alone, without successful implementation, has zero value. It has no credibility. Well, people may applaud you for trying, and people may give you a pat on your back, but they're not going to call you the innovator for that product because you've not yet successfully implemented it. And if somebody, after you implementing it, you fail at it, and somebody took that idea from you and successfully implemented that idea later, guess who's going to get the credit for it? Well, definitely the person who successfully implemented that idea, because that's the definition of innovation or an inventor. Innovation is the successful implementation of an idea. All right? So now let's get into the process of how do we innovate? What are there some steps to innovate? Sure, there are steps to innovate. You know, I'm one of the I can have the privilege to say that I'm one of the very few trainers in India who does full 1 days, 2 days innovation workshops, which are completely unique. And many times people come to my organization and to my training programs of innovation and say, Mitesh, these are tools, these are skills of innovation, these are definitions of innovation which we've never heard, we've never used them earlier. Why aren't you using something branded? Why aren't you using something world-renowned already? But then, hey, if I was to take innovation from Harvard or from Oxford from some book, and I would sell that back to you, what's innovative about it, right? If I'm going to do an innovation workshop, and if I'm not innovating in my workshop in the content of it, well, then I don't think I have the right to do an innovation workshop, right? So my grounds on which I started this innovation workshop was on that the content has to be new, the implementation has to be new, the methodology has to be crisp. So one of the things that happens in our workshop in innovation is that when people leave the workshop, they don't leave with the concept of innovation. They leave as practitioners of innovation because we do innovation in the workshop. Okay. So while I can't get into the whole day, 1 day, 2 days workshop with you right now on the video, I'd love to share a few ideas, a few tools, a few steps that I follow, which has helped thousands of people in my workshops from all kind of industries to innovate in their career or in their personal life and their professional life. Okay, so step one, what's the step one of the process of innovation? The very step one is ideation. Yes, what most people think is the end of innovation is actually the beginning of innovation, which is ideation. What do I mean by ideation? It means that you sit and you dedicate about 15 to 20 minutes of time to innovate, to just sit and innovate a lot of ideas about whatever you want to work on. So let's say, for an example, you're working in your company and you want to work on cost saving. Now, if you're working on cost cutting, cost saving in your organization, the first 15 minutes you don't make any decisions about what's innovative. You just simply create lots of ideas. Now, there's a rule in here. The rule that I tell people when you're doing ideation is all kind of ideas are welcome. Good ideas and bad ideas, both are welcome. And in fact, I believe that good ideas are always found in the middle of bad ideas, right? So you need bad ideas for the good ideas to also come along with you. So for 15 minutes, step one, just sit and create a lot of ideas. And at that time, don't ask yourself, is this idea useful? Is this a good idea? Is it a bad idea? All kind of ideas are welcome. just let ideas keep coming to you and just keep noting them down. All right. So that's the process. Step one of the process of innovation, ideation, create a lot of ideas. In my workshops, when we ask people to do ideation, I encourage people to come up with as much as 50, 60, 70 ideas in 5 minutes, 10 minutes maximum. All right. So step one, do the ideation. And while doing the ideation, which is while creating ideas, don't think right, wrong, good, bad, useful, unuseful. Don't think about all of that. Just create ideas. Okay. Now, once you got this list with you, here's the second step. The second step is to filter these ideas in two categories, is what I call as positive ideas and negative ideas. Now, what do I mean by positive and negative? I don't mean positive and negative as good or bad ideas. Here's what I mean by that. There's a definition for it in our workshop. Positive ideas are those ideas which are useful and independent to use. Now, what do I mean by useful and independent? Well, useful means it's an idea which is practical to implement. And you would know what you mean by practical, right? Because it's your area of work. For an example, in cost saving, if I'm saying that, let's say I want to cut the budget of all the travel plans. Is that really practical and usable? Might not. But let's say if I have an idea that says that we want to cut all business class traveling to economy traveling. Is that possible? Sure, that seems a little usable, right? So one, the idea has to be usable. It has to be useful. It has to be practical. And the second rule for filtering those ideas as positive ideas, other than the fact that they need to be useful and practical, is that they need to be independent for you to implement. Here's why I'm saying that. Let's say you have a great idea. It's useful, it's practical, but you need to now go to your top management, or you need to go to your family, or you need to go to, let's say, the political experts in the country, and you need to get a lot of sanctioning from them. You need to convince many, 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 many people, and it's going to be a difficult process to get that process of sanctioning done for that idea. Then it's too dependent on an idea, right? So a faster way of going into innovation is to try and look for ideas which are independent for you to use, something which is in your domain of control, your power of control, right? So remember, filter them into positive ideas, which means something which is usable and independent for you to implement. That's one category. The second category in which you put all these ideas into and filter them into is called the negative ideas, which means either these ideas are not useful, or, and it's an or, an and, or they're dependent. So any idea which is, let's say, useful but dependent goes into negative, or any idea which is independent to implement but unpractical, not really useful, again goes into the negative category. And of course, if it's unpractical and it's too dependent on someone to be getting permissions from to use this idea, again, goes into negative. So filter all these ideas in about 5 minutes into positive ideas, useful and independent, negative ideas, not useful, unpractical, and too dependent ideas. These are the negative ideas, right? That's step two. Filter your ideas down. Now comes to step three. Now you take all your positive ideas. Take all your positive ideas and now look at which one of these ideas are most profitable. Most profitable. Now, why do I say most profitable? Because in organizations, mostly, innovation happens for the sake of the bottom line. What is the bottom line? Profitability. Now, if you're doing innovation in your personal life, are you also looking at profitability there? Sure. Well, but the context, the definition of profit might change there. The profit definition for you might be what's the benefit that you get, what's the maximum benefit that you might get from some of these positive ideas. So if you're not looking at the negative ideas, we're just looking at the positive ideas which are useful and independent. And from those ideas, we are now looking for top three ideas which are most profitable, most beneficial to you as an individual in your personal life or professional life, for you and for everyone around you. Okay, so look for the most profitable ideas out of this whatever list of positive ideas that you've got. In my experience in my workshop, people actually create 50 to 60 ideas in about 5 minutes, and they filter them down, and the average filtration so far has been about 60-40, like 60 has been about negative ideas and 40% has been about positive ideas. So you take these 40% positive ideas and you filter them down into top three only profitable ideas. Once you got these profitable ideas, now comes to the step four. What's step four? You simply choose one profitable idea to start with. One profitable idea to start executing it. Now that's step four. That's a choice that's pretty simple. Now we go to the most important step, step five. When you start to execute step four, which is you take one profitable idea and you start to execute it, you want to be conscious. You want to make sure that you are able to observe what's not working. Where are you failing while executing that idea? So the question here is, what's not working to make the innovation successful? That's step five. So step five in my language is called as check what's not working and take feedback. Check what's not working while executing your idea and take feedback either from yourself or from people around you about what's not working. Why is the idea not being able to successfully implement? And believe me, most ideas, they don't immediately get successfully executed, right? There are some barriers, there are some limitations, there are some problems that you, some challenges that you might face across the way. You want to note what these challenges are. You want to note what these failures are. You want to note what, why is it not working? Why is it not making it successful? What are the interferences that are stopping you? So once you take some feedback here, then you go to step six. Step six is to change your strategy, change your approach, and implement again. Change your strategy, change your approach, implement again, and continue implementing. Until when do you do five and six? What is five? Take feedback. What is six? Change your approach, keep implementing it. Until you really reach what I call the final stage of innovation, step seven, which is successful implementation of the idea. So step seven is successful implementation of the idea. But you reach there only when you keep doing five and six aggressive enough. Five, take feedback. Six, keep changing your approach. Until when do you do that? Well, ask Thomas Edison. How many times did he try to keep learning from his feedback, from his failures, and keep changing his approach to make the bulb? Well, they say he tried 1,000 times, but that's not important. The question is, if you asked Thomas, why did you not give up? How many times would you continue to work on the bulb? What if you would fail 2,000 times? Well, I think Thomas said, you know, it doesn't matter how many times I failed, because every time I was just looking at feedback, I was seeing what's not working. So I know that I don't have to repeat what's not working, and I change my approach at step six, and I keep working on it. But still, you may still ask yourself the question, until when do I try? Well, here's the answer to that. If you're truly passionate about implementing what you're working on, then your answer is simple. As long as it takes. As long as it takes. But if you're not passionate about it, this question might come to you and you might ask yourself, is it really worth going all this effort? And if your mind says it's not worth it, yeah, then it's time to give up the idea and maybe work on another profitable idea that you've got in the list. But when you choose your profitable idea, maybe that's the right time to ask yourself, am I passionate about implementing this idea so much that I can keep going on to step five, taking feedback, and step six, keep changing the strategy until I reach the step seven, which is successfully implementing the idea? Okay, so that's the whole process of innovation. Let's do a quick recap of what we've learned so far. What is innovation? Firstly, how important innovation is. Innovation is not a luxury today. It's a necessity. We need it every single day of your life, everywhere. Even in your relationships, you need innovation, right? Because even your spouse today wants innovation from you to keep upgrading the level of your relationships today. So one, innovation is not, it's not a luxury. It's a necessity. Second thing we learned was, what is innovation? What's the definition? Innovation is the successful implementation of an idea. Now, then we got into the process of innovation. What's the process of innovation? Step one, ideation. Create lots of ideas. Step two, what's step two? You filter these ideas down into positive ideas and negative ideas. What are positive ideas? Usable and independent. What are negative ideas? Unuseful, unpractical, two dependent ideas. Those are negative ideas. Okay. Step three, what do you do with the positive ideas now? You take the positive list of ideas and you further filter them down into what? You filter them down into profitable ideas. Exactly, the profitable ideas. What is the step four? Step four is simple. You choose one idea from the top three profitable ideas that you've taken, or the top most three beneficial ideas that you've got, and start executing it. Step five, what is step five? Pretty simple. Take feedback when you're executing it. See what's not working. Take some feedback from yourself or from your surrounding or from your environment. And step six, keep changing your approach. And then you finally reach the step seven, which is successful implementation of that idea. Okay, so that's innovation video for you in about 20 minutes today. I hope the video served you. I'll see you in some other video next again. Thank you. Bye-bye.